morning, everyone. Today we're going to be talking about something that I am extremely passionate about, and that is the overall oral health of your pets. I believe that dental cleanings are an essential part of keeping your pet healthy. So that's what we're going to be talking about today. If you want to see this video, then just keep on watching. All right, and go. So why do we perform dental cleanings in the first place? So I'm going to insert some pictures of some dogs that have severe periodontal disease. You can see the infection and the pus. So periodontal disease is inflammation of the tissue that surrounds the tooth. When these things are left untreated, periodontal disease leads to severe oral pain. It can also result in tooth loss. It can lead to other major health issues. Things like heart disease, kidney disease, liver disease. Because if your pet has a bunch of bacteria and infection in their mouth that they're constantly swallowing, then that is going to lead to other issues. The signs of periodontal disease vary on the severity of the disease. The most common thing that we hear is that, you know, my pet is having bad breath, which is called halitosis. It is not normal for your pet to have bad breath. That usually means that there is an infection that needs to be addressed by your veterinarian. So if you have any pets at home, you should definitely lift up their lip and take a look at their teeth. If you see any tartar or inflammation of their gums, then they need to have a dental cleaning. It's always Chrissy.
Hi. This is the puppy.
So this is Sally. She just got checked in for her dental cleaning. So the first thing that I'm gonna do when I admit her into the hospital is I'm gonna check her over and make sure I don't see any abnormalities. I'm gonna get her weight and her temperature, her pulse and respiration, and then also take a look at her teeth. Definitely do need to be cleaned. You can see the tartar buildup on her molars and also on her canines.
Got in between.
I am gonna be placing an IV catheter in her cephalic vein so she can get IV fluids throughout her entire procedure.
In there, but said that I should have been. Hold back the river, let me look in your eyes. Hold back the river so I can stop for a minute and see where you are.
I am gonna give her a Serenia. What this is an anti-nausea medication. We give it to all of our patients that are undergoing any kind of anesthesia. So later when they go home, they don't have an upset stomach and they have an appetite and they're ready to eat.
We run our bikes into the sky.
Okay.
One thing to fall over.
So Dr. Stone is going to examine Sally to make sure she's okay to go under for anesthesia. And once she gives me the okay, I am gonna give her what we call DKB. It's a mixture of dextromethor, ketamine, and butorphanol. I'm gonna wait about 10 to 15 minutes until she goes to sleep and we'll get her intubated on the table. Scaling Sally's teeth, I do have her hooked up on a monitor so I can monitor her blood pressure, her heart rate, her respiration rate. I'm also monitoring her SpO2, which is the concentration of oxygen throughout her body. Becca here is monitoring her heart rate throughout the entire procedure, her monitor, and then we also have her hooked up on IV fluids as well. That's gonna help regulate her blood pressure so I can lower the fluids or raise them depending on whether her blood pressure is high or low.
Won't you let us on that, let us hold each other. Lonely water, lonely water, won't you let us on that, let us hold each other. Hold back the river, let me look in your eyes. Hold back the river so the river, hold back, hold back the river, let me look in your eyes. try to keep you close to me, but life got in between. Tried to square, not be in there, but say.
So after her dental cleaning, I am gonna sit with her until she is awake and moving around, walking on her own, and her temperature is normal. I do have our heater on her, and I'm just gonna sit with her until she's completely awake.
Stop for a minute and see where.
So Katie is going to be my example. She doesn't have any calculus or periodontal disease at all. I do a lot of at-home treats and oral care for her. She's 7 years old now. She's only had one dental cleaning in her life, but I'm very proactive about doing stuff at home for her. We'll take a look at her teeth. See, her gums are not red, and there's no tartar or plaque buildup on her teeth at all. The best way to prevent tartar buildup on your dog's teeth or inflammation of their gums is going to be brushing their teeth. However, realistically, not everyone is gonna brush their dog's teeth every day. So there are a ton of different dental diets you can use for their teeth. You can also do certain treats. You can do water additives. You can add stuff to their food. There's a whole bunch of stuff that you can do. There are some things that are a lot better than others, and I'll go over some of the ones that we carry and the ones that I use for Katie at home. Okay, so I personally use two products on Katie's teeth. The first one she absolutely loves. They're called Orvet. You can purchase these through your veterinarian if they carry them. They kind of look like a greenie. They look like this. And in the middle here, in this yellow part, there is medication that's built into these treats so that when she's chewing on it, it coats her tooth for 24 hours so tartar can't build up on her teeth. I love these. They make her breath smell so good, but it's also really good for her oral health as well. So the difference between this and a greenie is that this actually has medication in them. And the thing with greenies, they're not bad. I just think if I'm gonna spend money on something, I wanna spend money on something I know is gonna work. Okay, the next thing that I do for her teeth is perio support. This is actually our clinic bottle, but they come in like a 4 ounce bottle. These I know you can get either through your veterinarian or on chewy.com. I'll have that linked below, but this is just a powder. I also use this for my cat as well, but it's just a powder as you can see. And depending on their weight, you just put some of this powder on their food. You can use it for soft food, but it does work better, at least in my opinion, with hard food. What I do is get that powder, throw it on her hard kibbles, and kind of zhuzh it around. And that just will coat her kibbles, so when she's chewing on them, it's also, one, brushing her teeth, but it also creates the environment in her mouth to where that tartar cannot build up as fast. It doesn't have a taste, so that's why I use it for my cat, and he doesn't seem to mind it at all. All right, guys, that is it for this video. If you liked it, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!